Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's WA Gamers League Season Number 1. Clansu taking on TPM Academy. Map number 2 is about ready to come out here. It's Mirage joining you in the studio. I'm Bizer, and with me is Jared. My man, how are ya? You're allowed to talk, Jared. I've completely lost him. Oh, well. I love a bit of Jared. I'm going to unmute Bone since he's here as well. If he wants to talk, he can say hello.
Hello.
Hello. How are you, man?
Hello. Good. How are you? I reckon Jared's gone to go have a ciggy. I'm not going to lie.
Oh, really? Thinking he had heaps more time.
Probably.
That'd be right. I don't know. The players are still mucking around at the moment, so I'm a little concerned. But I believe your match is coming up next on stream.
Yes. We're about to go through vetoes because Joe did say just to start it.
Ooh.
So I don't know if you're just going to cast it like halfway through or what.
Oh, we'll probably jump in when we can, but yeah.
Cool.
We had the second map to go as it was a pretty close encounter battle. We will be there, okay. So I might leave you to it. I wonder when Jared's coming back. Never. That's right. This is your opportunity, WA Gamers, to give us a little bit of shout-out love. And at the moment, it looks like some people are going absolutely crazy, and Steve just being a god in there, modding like there's no tomorrow. I like it. If you guys like what you see, hit that follow button. Always good to have people following on. Guys are going to dot R. Carefree. Hopefully it can happen. Come on. All right. Looks like we're going into our knife round. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're finally here. About goddamn time. Let's get us into game. All right. And just forgive the overlays. I think we are on the wrong side. I'll fix it out. We'll see what happens. Carefree is what's coming through. Hopefully it works. I'm sure the guys can just... Well, someone's brought armor, so that's cheeky anyway. Wow. Okay. What do you do? What do you do when they troll you? What a train wreck. Yes, panic room. It is a train wreck. Shout out to Peak CSGO. There you go, mate. You can have one.
All right, buddy. Ready to go?
Pretty much Jared had a smoke. Oh, admin is all ready. We are all ready to go. About goddamn time. Jared, I had no idea you stepped out, buddy. I came back into the intro and all we got was crickets and a hail bale rolling across the stream.
I like to be mysterious.
I was a bit scared. Even Bones decided to step in and say hello.
Oh, how lovely.
That's it. Well, Bones is setting up for their match, and they're going to get going with their videos. So I'll be finding a little bit of information out on that, and if I can get a match report as well coming through, that would be great. As soon as this match is done, we'll be jumping on to the second one of the night. But we're finally in the knife round. And, well, they're going to be heading out to the team name. It's going to be a bit of fun. Take it away.
Just a man pop. A few trades going in.
It's a 5-piece beast on both sides, and they're all getting slaughtered.
Bricky's got this easy. He knows he's got him.
Oh! Well, there you go. TPM Academy, the second knife round in a row. And what are they going to do? Switch over? Please switch over. Make it life easy for me. I'm in an iron here. Okay, so they switched over. Fantastic. They have given me the overlay I wanted to go with. So, CT side for TPM Academy. And, well, I love Nightbot, and that's Nightbot and Warmod, and I love how the two names are up on the top. Don't get confused with it. We do have the overlay up, so Clansu is on T side, and the boys of TPM Academy sitting CT side. Well, predictions early on. What are we thinking, Jared?
I'm going to give the first three to Clansu on this. I feel like they're going to win this pistol. And then hopefully get that momentum leading in. Ooh, Skinny already gets dinked.
That was a pretty hard dink. They're delayed here. Now flashes out. That's a good nade into apartments. Going to push short.
Oh.
The aggressive game. They will pick it up.
And... Nature and Skinny both going down. We got two rotators coming through shop. And... Oh! Slick Rick takes the jump. It's short. It's going to cost him a few seconds.
He's got someone waiting for him as well. In default. Yes. So it's not going to be hard for Slick Rick. He's got a battle to contend with two in shop. Nice picks coming from... From Slick and then
gets traded.
Twisted, Ruthless now. That chair is the point. Acrolyte's actually picked it, so Raider needs to be careful about his back here. He's going to push the chair, misses the headshot. He's got it, but it's too close to call right now. It will be a hold by Ruthless, and he's just going to play this correctly. He does, turns around, takes the corner, and as you've predicted, Clan Zoo with the first. Good start by
Well played by Ruthless. He's got a lot of money off that, too. Two assists and two frags. So, CTs are opt into half buyback, so just pistols, oh, and a scout. So, armor only on one player, and then the scout, and then a few P250s, Deagle coming out as well.
UMPs are a pretty good buy for them, so spread at the moment.
Yeah, just a 2-on-2, three players towards mid for the terrorists. And the window smoke bouncing back. That's going to cost him a little bit of time. But Ruthless is slowly walking up connector. Could get shot in the back of the head.
Come on, Nate. You got to hit the headshots. Unfortunately, he doesn't get it. Ruthless is actually going to go hunt him as well. But crossover. Possibly in the making here. Turn the corner. They're going to head into this B bomb site right now.
It's two down to B with the bomb drop.
Sky's done well. There's a head popping out for default. He doesn't see. He finally goes now. Charging up, jumping through the air. He takes the frag. They're already in the house, ready to pop out here. Default just needs to get the bomb down. Raider. Gonna be a tough battle with the Deagle and the Scout for Slick Rick. I don't know what you can do here, but two players are lit. Troy's the one you need to really worry about.
Not very optimistic. Clanzu's got this in the bag.
Yeah. I think Rick was more on the side, just needed to put the pistol out and help his teammate out, whether you'd rotate through to the short side of the bomb site instead of going at the back, and that's where the trouble was at.
Yeah, he wasn't really rolling in the options either. I mean, if they both got to come through the market, there's only two spots for him, really, the hallway and the window, which means they can have one player dedicated to each line, and then the last one baiting for the clutch player if he needs. So, three players on bomb already taken down. We got one Tetris, one Pellas. Ooh! TPM already. Pulling out three easy frags. With the bomb down on site.
Walked into
it. Back to a 2v2. Default, quite tagged. Hasn't seen Raider yet.
Ruthless is, made a bit of noise. This allows the CT to list.
He's gonna hear that jump.
Oh, he heard the jump before, so he knows what's going on. But the bomb still not spotted.
Ooh.
Ruthless able to take a frag now. 1v2, guns in hand. Not gonna check the line. He gets one. The cross is there. Trey. Oh my God, he's absolutely
one hell.
Right down against the shot.
Slick Rick.
Very close for Slick Rick. TPM again.
Very big play.
Very lucky to get away with that one. It almost went against him with 2v1, but a good clutch out in the end.
So 1-2. And CTs will buy up here. Terrace buying up too. This should be interesting. Arclight only on a Deagle and Dougie only on a Tech 9 though.
I do apologize, I missed the AWP shot. Should pick up on that, guys. He's going to hold the short line and please do not peek, Nature. I know you're feeling like it. He's going to get a HE around.
Careful, just default.
Counter. He does pop out.
Oh, gets the frag on Raider.
Good CT connection frag. Molly comes down, puts him down a little bit. Fans are not sure where they're going at the moment. Still heaps of time on the clock for them to decide. They're starting to move.
Twister gets absolutely smashed by Arclight with the one tap.
Yeah, and funny enough, is Nature's been playing that line, making a lot of noise. and it was his eventual that AWP shot was just going to take him. So great patience coming out there from Ruthless as that bomb has been planted at the A bomb site. And well, poor old Skyne. He's going to have a bit of trouble to work through, and there's going to be someone waiting for him at the B bomb site, so nowhere to hide here. Mind you,
Dookie's
waiting.
Oh, he's got a line on him. Oh. So there goes that buy.
Crouched out.
The crab walk always pays off. I mean, it's science.
Yep.
Well, so what are we looking at?
A little bit of control. First round where they've kept all the players up. Going to be buy and an eco coming from TPM. And we've seen this before. The question is, does Mirage the map that can actually pick frags up? Ruthless with the first. Looking for more. Slick Rick is caught in an awkward position. And he's going to have another molly. He has to move, and Jonsky. Ruthless will take it. Very good molly to bring him out of the play there. And cleverly fought. TPM has been caught out on the push. Forced around the corner. Now out of random. Default to flip. Picks up the frag. One lowers. Oh, default.
Twisted going for
Kip. So he's just going for the spray. And the clean out will be there. And another round going to Clanzu. TPM Academy not working with the echo this time.
Yeah. 5-1 as well. So Clanzu's money's building up quite nicely. Troy and Doug is still sitting on one frag apiece. Twisted Raider and Skinny. The same for the CT team. So we got 3 players towards the A ramp, hopefully going for a smoke take. 2 frags already, but Ruthless sitting on 20 health. So he's cleared on the balcony, he knows Olaf, Sandwich, and Gay Spot is still to be cleared. CT as well.
Oh, no,
maybe Nature can get a few.
Well, 5-7 in hand. Flashed and mollied with a smoke in the line of that. Slick is up there with him. That's going to be a hard battle to get and everything. I think they should just head for the exits. Try and pick a gun up that way. If they can combine their pistol with a nice crossfire, at least they can go that way.
Skinny's about to get smashed by default. There it is. Ooh! Picks up the frag. And here Douglas is going to stop him getting the AK. Can he get him? There he is.
Oh. The site is clearing out now. This is interesting. Troy's going to stay there. An opportunity here for Nature, and he hasn't gone to take it, so the bomb's right there, and he's going to let that go. He could have worked in and got a ninja, at least had a teammate, because his clans have completely backed out and left one there.
No kits on the team, though, so...
No kits, but, you know, you can take the one at CT, then and then... I dare say you have enough time to be able to defuse if you go straight on the ninja, if you can work a teammate out to sort of go on that. It's a hard one to sort of comprehend. You're probably right, fans who are going to have it and backing out of that, but Academy now the buyout. They need to make this count. Slick Rick, AWP, Ruthless being the man for the T side right now.
Lots of mid presence being shown with Slick Rick posting up on that palace line, and this is the only round that it's been left empty. Same with A ramp, so as it stands, 3 players towards the mid for Clanzu, slowly working short, but there's a gap in that smoke. One already up in the connector. It's very dicey for them.
Clanzu taking the time right now. Hot flash for Doogie. The opportunity stairs, lights up the box. Slick Rick. Not good for him, that's the AWP down. And dare say that position, you don't want to be playing when it's smoked out.
Bomb Dougie!
Bomb working its way onto the B bomb site, however, and Nature now, he has to pop the corner, he does. AWP's down for both teams. Now all about the assault rifles. Nature lighting up too, default with the trade out through the return, but CTs have not moved. In fact, they've rotated around. HG on the screen onto Acrolyte will make the bomb drop at the van. Around going the favour of TPM right now. They're cleaning out. It's 12-1. He has to go. Skyne not able to stop that one.
Clanzu bringing the goods.
He had the bomb drop, but Clanzu just making sure the trade.
Clanzu are doing very, very well at managing their economy while keeping this very, very expensive for the CTs as well. And they know that at any given point, if they just play the timer, there's going to be no nades coming out and no fancy orps or anything either. So all I need to do is just let them run into their lines pretty much. As it's about to happen at ramp. Can he get this? Go on, Ricky, get him. Arclight takes him down. Troy with the nade to get the second.
Yeah, as soon as that flash had come out and also the molly, should have backed off. I think they were just getting too aggressive there, TPM. It's a scary fraud right now. This is really heavily favored in Clan Zoo. The experience starting to show Ruthless really strong on that AWP. And even the eco rounds just haven't been convincing.
Default.
Also like how Cash was. It's a completely different story on Mirage.
Yeah, Default with a delicious lurk coming out there. He's crept all the way through B site to CT. Shot old mate in the back of the head.
Radio with a Zeus. Don't tell me you do it, mate. Why didn't you buy a Zeus in the first place? Like, it's a waste of money.
Well, if you're on an economy round and you know somebody's going to run into your crosshair, you might shoot him in the head with the USP and get a 60 tag with no kill.
Oh.
The Zeus, they're just asking to die.
Acrolyte stepped in, so he's going to be able to get himself a an AK. But he pops out where Ruthless is holding a short line. Unlucky, my friend, and... Well,
7-1.
He'd be clever not to approach this, because AWP looking straight down his noose. Oh, if I was Ruthless, I'll just have a couple ping shots at the box. Why not?
Nah, he definitely needs to slave this. Slave this, what am I about? Definitely needs to save this.
Oh, he's gonna get it!
He just got CS-go'd.
It's a tough line story for TPM and Kelly right now, and this is getting tough for them. Very quickly, you're saying this game could go either way, whether it was a, whether it would be heavily sided to one team, and certainly happening right now. Clan Zoo with 7 consecutive rounds, now bye for TMP. Hopefully they can hold this one. And this time something different. The apartments has been slightly aggressive. The information has been put there. Maybe this is a chance for a rotation. Now, Nature's playing up short.
See, with all this presence underneath towards the B site, besides Default. Sorry, don't go.
No, keep going.
With all the presence towards the B site, besides Default, chilling back towards the T spawn, if... who's that A player chilling over here? Oh, he's already rotated. If that A player pushed Pelos and saw nobody, he could almost instantly say to his team, it's going to be a late B or a fast B, and then everyone would just flood over to the B site and just mow them down as they enter, which is what seems to be happening now.
This is not a bad round, and they've got the numbers in their favour now. T's are forced out. 52 seconds remaining. I think they're going to look for these shots. Again, strong
What's
play
Nuggie
coming.
Think?
Troy, AWP in the mid, will flick a line onto Slick Rick. But you said it yourself, man, they're getting outnumbered and outgunned.
Yeah, they're playing the bomb very, very late in the round too, at this point in time. So Troy and Dougie are just trying to go for the frags more than anything. But Dougie's on the site, and there's Troy's going to be booking it up the palace now.
Well, they both come out of jungle here.
Neither of them have an AWP though, so if he drops down, if he just man modes it, he can be at that plant easy. And then the rotator is going to be coming from... Is that CT? Or is he behind him?
He's wasted a little bit of time.
Oh, connector, sorry.
He'll be able to get that. Now stepping on the line. Troy flicks it. Now leaving the one-on-one.
1v1.
Not a good gun. It gets banked down. 36. Needs to hold the line. Hoping for
it.
He's getting banked through the box. He now turns the corner. He'll be clutched out by Twisted.
Got a little too cheeky.
We'll defuse the bomb and pick the second up. It wasn't the gun that he needed to be on. If anything, maybe back to the pistol. But you're right. He kept standing behind that box. The spray coming from Twisted. Very clever by him to realize that the AWP not really going to get an aggressive line to go. So to spray the box down. And don't pick that stairs, because that is the number one position where everyone will go just for a little bit of leverage. And the crosshair's always there. So good round by TPM. But there's a lot of rounds they need to pick up. Be respectable if they can get this back, but Clan Zoo, they've got so much cash to go.
Yeah, definitely. And also, Famuses without nades aren't really doing them any favors, so in any given angel, it's not going to favor the TPM lads by any means.
Well, they're out in the air bomb site, and there's a few coming out here, stairs, and just fall through the smoke.
That was an easy fake.
Getting burned. And there goes the B player. But that bomb is nowhere near A, and there's absolute juking coming from Clan Zoo. They've called it out right now, and Skynes will be told to come back because there's still players there. Meanwhile, the bomb walks itself in to the A bomb site. Sorry, the B bomb site.
Go on, default. Get him. Bang. Yeah, TPM is getting picked apart right now. They're very unsure with what they need to be doing.
That was a real convincing fake, wasn't it?
It was, but the B player before he left should have just taken a cheeky jump, you know, just at the van, not for a fight, just like a cheeky peek, see if he saw anything. I'm not saying it would have been game-changing, but it would have given him the information he needed to tell his mates.
Default, the cheeky three-piece fade for him, cleaning out that round. Clan Zoo continuing on their winning ways. There was a reset, well, a round one for Academy, but nowhere near a reset of anything. So much money. They are coming down a little bit. Troy has enough to drop. But T-Sides, I think they could take this through and maybe have a 13-2 half. TPM Academy just haven't been convincing on the C2 side.
Yeah, definitely. And even if this round goes south for the Clan Zoo boys, Troy can still drop two AKs and buy himself one with head armor. So they're not going to be running out of money anytime soon. And as you can see, they're just steamrolling them, to be honest. Yeah.
I'm not sure what was up with nature. His crosshair didn't move as the T came around the corner. So I'd feel a little bit of a sticky mouse situation, maybe. Oh, nature.
Who knows what he was doing in that break? Look down, Dougie, look down.
Oh, here's it. Slick Rick will pick up the AK on the drop of the box.
I think Default might be able to get at him just in time. Because if he clears this ramp, he's gone. Oh. Gets the second. Will he get the third? No. Cake the jump. Look out. And Troy gets the trade.
Yeah, they're not going to hold on. They will take guns away. Make a rebuy happen.
So 5v2 with Troy sitting on 12k now. He would have been better off dropping his teammates instead of making them waste all their money.
Ouchies.
7 round lead in the half. So we're on round 12 now. I think that at this point in time, TPM just need to slow down and try and get an AWP up or two. And just have an AWP anchoring a site instead of taking that mid fight, because these Clan Zoo are just going for them like non-stop, not really slowing down for anything.
Tough battle at the moment, Slick Rick. He's about to experience the full force of what this Clan Zoo team have to offer. They're looking at the bomb site and pretty much nail them.
Right. Raider's about to drop it stairs too.
Raider. Oh, there was a knife coming from Acrolyte. Cheeky little bugger. Not going to happen. He gets taken on the stairs. Nice trade out. Leaving Skyne.
Ooh, Skinny.
Sorry?
Gets Skinny.
I've been calling him Skyne the whole time. My bad.
Nah, that's alright. And the crab walk paid off that time and then got traded out. So 2-10. It's scoreboard's kind of flipped on its head since last game. I mean, Raider was pulling
it's not so
big
anymore,
numbers last game, as was Arclight, and then now they seem to be taking a backseat with the other guy stepping up. Default and Ruthless, though, doing very, very well right now.
They're just
very confident in their play. And as you can see, the A takes are paying off tremendously because they're not dicking around at Tetris and waiting for stuff to happen. You know, they're busting out onto the site and taking the duels. So CTs either need to peek or just surrender the map control entirely, and that's what's winning them these rounds. They're just going for it and it's paying off.
It's full gun round right now, and CT's going to work through the jungle. The trade coming, yes.
Skinny on 30.
All three of them know that he's going to pop flash out. Oh, he's going to peek as well. Which is not great because he's crossed and now Ruthless is going to have the line.
He's stuck.
He's stuck and he's not coming out of there. Very well, Ruthless has given him an opportunity to go.
Bang.
He didn't go any better, but he didn't go anywhere. Default finally gets it. Comes around the corner with the AK. Clan Zoo with round 11. Now heading into round 14. I can see it has gone 13-2. I called it about 5 rounds ago and I think it's going to happen.
Yeah, well, as I said, steamroll. It's just one of those maps, really, but to be honest, if this goes 11-4 at the half, or even 13-2, 12-3, it can always come back to like a 16-14 in the end, as soon as TPM gets harassed. You just have a... Mirage is one of those maps where as a terrorist, you always have options. Like, whenever something just isn't working, you're just like, alright, I'll just do this instead. Change it up, you know? Ooh. Ruthless. Smashes nature.
Nature goes down, and own house at the moment. Gonna pop a whole lot of utility at him. And that will hit around 10.
12.
Dougie with two. Yeah. You know, on a clan zoo, continuing to move through this. It's risky play. Needs to come out here. AWP from Skinny. There's two there. So they've saved tremendously just to get around three.
So everybody on the TT team is sitting on $0. And lowest money on the terrorist team is 62.50. Yeah. I don't think there's been a round. Sorry. Hang on. Let me backtrack. Yep. Two rounds of the past 15 where they've had less than three players around alive at the end of the round. That's very, very smart play. And very good economy management as well. And a lot of killing.
Second ult down. Two M4s left to go. It'll be a planet A. And, well, there's no point saving Skinny. My friend, get moving. So do you, Radar.
He's hungry for that feed. He wants to fatten up. Go on, lad. Oh, gets taken down by Arclight. It's a lot to Radar.
Clutching a voice.
And he gets smashed.
Kansu, take the halftime, ladies and gentlemen. 13-2. So much work for TPM Academy. And if Mr. Joe himself, X, is in the other match, please give us an update with Ground Zero and TPM, the main team. I believe they are live. And after this match is concluded, we will be jumping over to that one to bring you the main team in its all its glory. We're getting into the second half right now. Jared, TPM Academy, now T-side. This is going to be hard because Kansu, they're strong on CT.
That is very true. And also, they have a lot of mid presence showing early on in this round, but it's not so much the numbers as the range, you know? The USP is just one tap to the head, see ya, you're gone. Glock, it's two to the head, I think, at range, or one to the body, one to the head. Very hit and miss sometimes. I mean, Glock's one of those 99 and 12 kind of guns, you know?
Default one, bomb sees it, drops it down by the van. He's holding well and he's given time to his teammates to get into the bomb site.
TPM. Short player drop. Default,
it is now
check
a
it.
Shootout. It's going to come out. Ruthless will pick up the van. And that is another round down. Clan Su picking up the pistol. And right now, leaving TPM Academy with not many options left in the bank to go. They have to force up here or make something happen because that's what Clan Su are doing.
Default is just very stubborn, refuses to die. What was that, three kills I think he got? Moving from bench to short, and then Ruthless just tapping everyone else's heads.
Well, TPM.
Going for the A take.
There's no utility for him as well, and this is where Clan Su can play the time and the clock. Continue to smoke and molly up that connection.
One dead.
However,
three up the way. Oh, the Swag 7, just delicious. Best gun in the game. And, Default steals Troy's kill.
I think we're going to map this down. I think I'm going to call this. I don't think TPM can go here. Not much money for them either, so Deagles are in the hand. Couple of flashes and smoke to go. I'm going to pencil in 16-2.
They put up a valiant fight.
Yeah.
They're just getting outclassed, really. The Clan Zoo is definitely a strong team, and one of the ones that people need to be very wary of leading into the next few weeks of the competition. Especially since they're playing a very loose style, but still covering each other, you know?
Yep.
Flashing their teammates into places, covering angles. 3v2, see if Nature can go for another one.
Did Dookie double flash CT, Con?
I believe he did.
What?
Ooh, Arclight smashes Nature. Last player alive, Radar, sitting at top mid. He's got the Desert Eagle Blaze. Oh, don't do it. I saw you cheeky devil.
Alright, Raider is playing with what time he has left. And trust me, it's not much. He's going to be able to evade that. But they're coming for him. And they're waiting. Oh, he's got a molly.
He's about to get smashed.
I thought he was going to molly himself and take
good
a,
game.
Take a kill out. The 16-2 is penciled in. ClanZoo finishing the 9-up with ease and absolutely dominating that one. Wow. Well, what a game that was. TPM Academy not able to pick one up. They go down in their first series of the week 2-0. We sort of expected it to go either way. I did say TPM, maybe the opportunity on Keish and ClanZoo, obviously a lot stronger on Mirage, to have the 1-1. And it was the opportunities that TPM Academy could have had, but not tonight.
Yeah, it was... The first game was definitely very interesting. Close game indeed. And then just slowly but surely saw the lead slip away from him. And I think it put him a little bit on tilt leading into the second map, but more than that, it gave ClanZoo the boost they needed to be like, you know what, we can just play the game we want to play the game, and they can't do anything about it. And that's why I would just go, go, go nonstop. There were some very, very short rounds, and also very few aim battles lost throughout that entire game that went in... TPM's favor, sorry. So, all in all, I think ClanZoo, one of the stronger teams as it stands.
Yeah, not going to deny. They've been around for a little while. Sometimes they change their lineups as well with different people, but they have been working quite hard. Mirage is probably more expected to be the map, and you know what they're saying with Dust2 now being banned out and Inferno brought in to the play group, that Keish is being more of a Dust 2, so a lot of teams are finding the home turf on Keish, and I think maybe that's where TPM had their advantage, and they made the most of it as well. CT side Deagles picking up rounds and guns, very, very well done by TPM, but when they try to replicate that again on Mirage, that seemed not to work, and I think ClanZoo cotton on to how aggressive they were being on their pushes. I also think a couple players, TPM, could have thought about rotating around on Mirage as well. Nature, a little bit too obvious at short, being worked around. Some crossfires should have been changed up with B, maybe potentially some stacks, because ClanZoo had a field day going through the A-bomb site. They enjoyed it a lot. And the A-bomb site, it was heavily contested with a lot of trade-outs. But yeah, at the end of the day, we see ClanZoo as a team that will mostly hunt for frags. And once they get a couple, they then hit a site. So if you can hold out your time against ClanZoo, make sure you don't lose anyone. Force them into positions where it's going to be the one-on-one battle, and you've just got to beat them by aim. That's where the key is going to be, beating ClanZoo on the maps. Maybe chuck the Inferno out there and prack that map, because they'll probably go, oh, we don't want to know about it, you know? So it'll be interesting. Those maps will probably be banned. Any final thoughts this game before we move on to the next one?
No, I think everything's really been covered. I'm just... really impressed with ClanZoo's performance, and glad that they could showcase their skills.
Okay, all right. What we're going to do is we're going to go to a 10-minute break to come into this. I need to get all the information. So apparently I haven't got any information on the next match, so I can't join it for you guys. As soon as I get that all through, we'll get up to date. I do believe the boys are playing right now. That is Ground Zero and TPM, the main team. And they're halfway through in the match. Don't know what about map it is, but I'll get that all sorted out, ladies and gentlemen. So stick around. Plenty more CSGO action here. WA Gamers League Season number one. First stream night on the Buys RL TV. The third game of the week. And we're going into the fourth, which will be the next one. The good old Ground Zero and TPM. We're back very soon.
Yeah. Are you?